staff member.
This is reporting as vocals.
Okay. Ready?
Yep.
Start record, start broadcast.
Start broadcast.
Okay.
Yay.
Okay, hello. Hi, this is Claudia from Muscle Talk 101. I'm at the Steel Gym. I'm with the Iron Coalition. And this is Manny Kirby.
Yo, what's up?
And there goes the shirt. The shirt is out, Manny.
Yes, it is. The shirt is out.
Look at it. Look. Look at this shirt. Look at that.
I-R-O-N-C-O-L-I-P-O-N. Iron Coalition.
See? Look at these people. The shirt is here. The shirt is here. Tell me about the shirt. Tell me how they can get it.
Well, you can get the shirt by emailing me, ironcoalition@gmail.com. Send us the size that you want. It's $20 for shipping and handling, which is included. Ironcoalition@gmail.com. I have white t-shirts, black t-shirts. I think blue. I have a few t-shirt colors. The only one that stand out the most is the white and black ones. White ones. Those are the ones that stand out the most. I also have tank tops, sweatshirts, and whatever else, but this is just one logo. The other logos will be coming up soon.
Okay. So listen. Let's take a look at this shirt, y'all. Look at this shirt. Look. Iron Coalition. Now, this is a message to all you people out there that thought that this shirt wasn't going to come out. Manny got his own shirt. So I just want to let you know that all the people, thank you for your, your support.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
To my show, to the Iron Coalition.
What's the name of your show again?
Muscle Talk 101. I got three shows. I got Muscle Talk 101. I got MTR 101. Let me see what else I got. I got my international show, which is Muscle Massive, blogspot.com. Let me see what else. And I write for the Examiner. I have my other blogs. And I have this TV show right here. So
we doing it, Pitt. So where are you based out of, Claudia?
I'm based out of New York and Florida.
And when you're in New York, what more do you do in New York? Do you travel a lot to places?
Yes, I've been to England, I've been to Canada, I've been to, I've been to Florida, I've been to Vegas, I've been to California, I've been to, recently, where did I go recently?
Crazy?
No. The last place I went to Canada, thrice, and I went to the Paul Dillett,
bodybuilding figure, classic.
The whole thing, the whole thing. Because I want everybody to know that Paul Dillett is a cool dude. Hi, Paul! I know you probably don't remember me, but you remember this?
He tall as hell.
Yes,
he's tall. 6'4"?
He's huge.
Is he still big, or is he just tall?
He's big, and he's tall, and you should see him in the suit.
Oh, he looks massive in the suit.
Oh my God, it looks like that is more than a tablecloth on him. That is too much material for one big man. So I just want to say, Paul Dillett, I'm hanging out with Manny Kirby at the Iron Coalition here. Let you know, talk to my man, he's got it going on.
Iron Coalition, baby.
That's right, Iron Coalition, make sure you check it out. Iron Coalition, what's the website for it?
Well, right now we're just off of Facebook, Iron Coalition Network, and Iron Icyware, Icyware and Iron Coalition Network, and Iron Coalition, all three. Iron Coalition, baby, you're coming all the way live. Come see you strong. Look at that. That's me, Iron Coalition.
Yeah.
So Claudia, tell us, how did you get into interviewing people?
Wow, you want to hear that story again?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, what happened was is that I was writing, I hooked up with this girl. She's a female bodybuilder. We no longer talk anymore. And I ain't going to mention her name because I don't want to make her relevant. Okay, the whole point is that the guy that had a radio show, and he took all my blogs and was hitting number one on Blog Talk Radio. So what I did is that I told I got upset, and then I asked him about it. I said, listen, you're using my stuff, so I'd like to get credit for it. So the radio show host told me to F you, I'm going to do what I want. I said, okay. So what I did is that I was friends, and I respected someone, a t-shirt person, and I told him, I said, listen, I don't like what this guy is doing, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to make my own show. The next day, I got threatening calls and threatening emails. Okay, can anybody see me here? Okay. I got threatening calls and threatening emails saying that, you know, you're full of S. I can't say this.
What is that with S?
Sugar honey, I see. Yes. And that, you know, you can't, you ain't nothing, you ain't never gonna be nothing.
Wait, I have to imply something here. Nobody in the right mind can tell somebody who or what they are or what they're
exactly.
going to be, nothing like that.
Exactly.
They don't have the right to say, you're not going to be this, you're not going to be right that.
Exactly.
So anybody out there, if anybody says that to you, tell them to take a week off and kiss
yes.
it off.
And he said that my blogs ain't nothing, he could do better without them, he didn't have to read nothing like that, I ain't nothing. So I said to the t-shirt maker, that which I don't want to make him relevant either, he opened his mouth and told the radio show host that I was going to get a radio show, but I wasn't a radio show for myself, but I wasn't really serious about it, okay? What happened was is that the next day I got threatening emails, calls, all types of stuff saying that you ain't this, you do a show, you'll never be me, you'll never make it. What I did was that I got on Blog Talk Radio, and I noticed that you get 30 minutes for free, so I had my first bodybuilder on the show, which was Christopher Hudley, and of course things started going wrong in the beginning of the show, and that show was number one because people thought I was funny, was trying to get my connection back on the show. Then another guy heard me talk, and then the bodybuilders kept talking, and then I had Vince Taylor on the show, which is a good friend of mine. Hi Vince. I had Hayatada Yamagishi, IFBB Pro Will Harris, and basically almost all of Facebook athletes that want to be seen, because most of the time these magazines and these radio shows only want big people. They think that that's going to make a show. No, that doesn't make a show. What makes a show is that to watch somebody start from the beginning, from the bottom, and work their way up and blow up. That's how I get my thrill. Okay?
Okay.
So that radio show host that told me that I couldn't do it, guess what, bitch? I'm number two today.
Oh.
I don't see you anymore.
She said, biatch.
I don't see you anymore. Mm. I don't hear from you. I don't see your videos anymore. I don't see your little events anymore. What happened?
Is she like Where's Elmo?
I would say.
Or was it Where's Waldo? Where's Waldo?
Much. Yeah.
I'm talking about somebody I don't even know about.
Yeah. But anyway, that's the whole thing. So my focus is to get bodybuilders out there, people that need to be seen, people that all these magazines don't focus on. That's why I'm working on my own magazine. That's why I'm working with the Iron Coalition and doing my thing with them. Thank you, Manny Kirby, very much for Manny's managing my business. And number three, that's why I have three radio shows. One, Muscle Talk, another one for musicians and actors, and my international show that is seen all over the world. Boom! Now what?
Booyah!
Boom. Have a nice day.
All right.
Got any last words here?
Let's talk about sponsors. How do you feel about sponsors? Those who want to sponsor you, you want to sponsor. How they work with athletes and all that.
Okay, this is my opinion about sponsors because, you know, as you know, that sponsors always close their books in the month of November. And it's kind of hard to get sponsorship for athletes because they're not really paying out as they used to. Now, back in the 80s, it was everybody. You was a pro, you got a sponsorship. Now, these days, they're not doing it because it could be one for the recession, or two, they could be making the money and then not wanting to help an athlete. Now, my opinion is that, yes, you can give an athlete, you know, pills and supplements and things like that. That's not enough.
But what if that sponsor and the athlete have to come to that agreement on a month-to-month term basis, or a clothing company, say that's what they had to offer right now? Is that still good enough? Do you think that's good enough?
No.
They think you should get paid as well?
They should get paid.
Or they should be doing demos, or doing, I mean, personally, I'm sponsored. I like to go everywhere and do everything. That's what I think they should be doing. It's a 50-50 thing. I never had a problem, and I'm still doing it. I just wanted you to give out some kind of information to the newbies, the people who want to come out and do it.
This is what I think. This is what I think that would work for a sponsor. Don't send your information to info@ the supplement company, because somebody from customer service is pulling your pictures, and guess what they're doing? They're deleting it. Because the only thing they're focusing on is the business coming in, not your picture. That's a fact. So what you got to do is that you got to send your information, talk to the sales manager. or the marketing company of that supplement company.
Well, how about you find out the person who owns the company?
Or even the person that owns the company.
The person who owns the company usually has a Twitter. So you find out the name of the person, the company you want to work with.
Mm-hmm.
Don't just go to any company. Find a company that you like, that you know about. They will ask you a whole bunch of questions.
This is what I think, in my opinion. I think that you should go to companies that are just starting out. Because, like, supplement companies that are just coming out. Just like I have a radio show and I'm just coming out. It's better that way because then you have more control. You can actually work side by side with that person and both of you can grow together. Marketing is the key. When you go to these big supplement companies, they already have their guys already. Okay? And you may not get enough of what the other big guys are getting that's been around for a while. So what I would do is, like, if you go to AXYZ nutrition company, which is just starting out, the best thing for you to do is go to them. They might not be able to pay you right now, but if you work with them and they get the revenue, you both can work together and do things, and maybe you might even be a partner in that company. Because now they need you.
Like Flex Wheeler.
Pretty much, I guess. I don't know anything about that.
Well, Flex, he the man, you know. He started out as a sponsored athlete, as far as I know or remember, or maybe I don't remember right, but now he got his own thing going on. I mean, he's a man.
I think the best person to go to is an ex-bodybuilder that has a nutrition company. Because they know that the struggles they went through to get there, so they can understand what you're going through. If you're being sponsored by somebody who's never competed, I think it's kind of hard because they don't understand the business. The only thing they understand is, okay, well, how much is coming in? And they're not very patient with collecting revenue. They'll probably say, well, we don't need this guy anymore because he's not doing anything for us. It's better for you to get go under a pro athlete that has a nutrition company. And then, you know, they understand you understand them. And then business will flow. That's just my opinion.